Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, on this first day of June, the Church celebrates the memorial of Saint Justin the Martyr. In spite of the threat of torture and death, Justin remained steadfast to the Lord. Let us ask the intercession of Saint Justin that we too may always be loyal to the Lord in spite of the persecutions that we experience. To make ourselves less unworthy of this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge that we are all sinners in need of God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the folly of the cross wondrously taught Saint Justin the Martyr the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ, grant us through his intercession that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Our reading from the letter of Saint Jude. Beloved, remember the words spoken beforehand by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. Build yourself up in your holy faith, pray in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, and wait for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ that leads to eternal life. And those who waver, have mercy. Save others by snatching them out of the fire. And the others, have mercy with fear, abhorring even the outer garments stained by the flesh. To the one who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you unblemished and exultant in the presence of his glory, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority from ages past, now, and for ages to come. Amen. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
O God, you are my God, whom I seek For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth, parched, lifeless, and without water.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary, to see your power and glory and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of the banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. Please stand.
Let the word of Christ dwell in your richly, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples returned once more to Jerusalem. As he was walking in the temple area, the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders approached him and said to him, "By what authority are you doing these things? Or who gave you this authority to do them?" Jesus said to them, "I shall ask you one question. Answer me, and I will tell you by what authority I do these things. Was John's baptism of heavenly or of human origin? Answer me." They discussed this among themselves and said, "If we say of heavenly origin, he will say, 'Then why did you not believe him?' But shall we say of human origin?" They feared the crowd, for they all thought John really was a prophet. So they said to Jesus in reply, "We do not know." Then Jesus said to them, "Neither shall I tell you by what authority I do these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning. Because of the Feast of the Visitation yesterday, the Gospel was replaced with the story of the visit of Mary to her cousin Elizabeth. But if not, no, the Gospel yesterday should have been about Jesus cleansing the temple. You remember that story. Jesus went to the temple and saw the many money changers changing monies and people selling animals and making the temple a marketplace. So Jesus was angry. And because of that, he took a whip and pinaghahampas yung mga nagtitinda at sinabi niya, "Get out of this place." Now, this gospel of today is a continuation of the gospel of that story. And that is why the scribes, the chief priests, and the elders were asking Jesus, by what authority are you doing these things? Sino ka para gawin mo yan? Sino ka para linisin mo ang templo? Sino ka para manggulo dito? So hindi siya sumagot ng diretsahan. Instead, Jesus asked them, okay, you want to know where my authority comes from? First, answer my question. And then, he told the story of John the Baptist. The baptism of John, where did it come from? From heaven or from earth? And this is the dilemma of the chief priests and the elders and the scribes. If they say from heaven, Jesus would say, why did you not believe him? Pag sinabi naman nilang, well, gawa-gawa lang yan ng tao. Lagot sila sa mga tao. And therefore, they chose to play safe. And they said, we do not know. Playing safe, iwas pusoy. Kaya sabi ni Jesus, well, kung hindi nyo alam, hindi ko rin sasabihin kung saan galing. Kasi ang punto ni Jesus ay sabihin, ang ginagawa ko ay galing sa gusto ng Diyos. My authority is divine. But he did not say that because they refused to answer his question. And you know, that is the sad thing. There are people here, now, in our time, people who chose to play safe. Ayaw namin makialam dyan. Baka kami maapektuhan. They would rather keep quiet, say nothing, close their eyes, even if they see some injustices happening right before their eyes. A fellow worker is being abused, they kept quiet. A child is being abused, the parent chose to keep quiet. Citizens who are being abused, killed, and some people chose to keep quiet. The world is not safer because there are people who chose to keep quiet. We do not know. That was the answer of the chief priests and the scribes. They played safe. Not like Justin the Martyr. He was given a choice. Betrayed Jesus, worship the gods of the Romans. Instead, Justin said, no. Even if it would mean my death, I would rather stay loyal to Jesus. And that is why he was killed. Tortured first, and then beheaded. But he chose to take side. Mga ginigili kong kapatid, sana kapag nahaharap tayo sa mga sitwasyon na dapat tayong mamili, ay hindi tayo matakot na gawin ang tama. Ulitin ko, sana kapag nahaharap tayo sa mga sitwasyon na dapat tayong mamili, gawin natin ang tama. Amen.
Please stand.
Through the gospel, Christ speaks to us with words of eternal authority and deed of healing power. Through him, let us pray with confidence as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may continue to teach Christ's eternal truth with authority. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hearts of world leaders may not be hardened as they hear Christ's voice today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those considering the religious life may seek to follow the will of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our blameless and holy lives may cast away the unclean spirits at work in our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may enjoy the radiant dawn of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father all-powerful, we place before you our needs and pray confidently for your help and mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord, that we may celebrate worthily these mysteries which Saint Justine strenuously defended. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr Justine, poured out like Christ's to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy,
holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Justin the Martyr, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Refreshed by heavenly food, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that attentive to the teaching of Saint Justin the Martyr, we may abide at all times in thanksgiving for the gifts we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tomorrow is the solemn feast of the Corpus Christi, the most holy body and blood of Christ. The masses will be 8 in the morning, 10 in the morning, and 6 in the evening. And before the evening mass, there will be the transfer of the Blessed Sacrament from Santa Cruz Church to the Manila Cathedral. So it will be arriving maybe around 5:30. So I invite you to witness this procession of the Blessed Sacrament in honor of Jesus, whose body and blood are being offered for our salvation. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.